Здравствуйте! Доброе утро! Добрый день! Добро пожаловать на урок русского языка! Хорошо! Итак, сейчас мы изучаем урок номер 11. Урок номер 11. And we are in a very important part of our textbook that deals with perfective and imperfective verbs, the aspects of the Russian verb. And we are trying to figure out why we have these two groups of verbs in the Russian language and how we can use them appropriately. So, perfective verbs and imperfective verbs, that's what we are talking about. So, let's take a look at this. Aspects of the Russian verb. And these are our new terms that are extremely important for us now. Imperfective verbs and perfective verbs. Ну, хорошо. So, do you remember what perfective verbs express? Perfective verbs express total, complete acts or events. I already wrote this letter. I completed my homework. I have read this book. I have done this. Let me give you a few examples. Итак, посмотрите, пожалуйста. Это журнал. Я уже прочитала этот журнал. I already read this magazine. I know what it's about. I'm finished with it. Я уже прочитала этот журнал. Итак, посмотрите, пожалуйста. Это письмо. Я уже написала это письмо. I wrote the letter. I don't have to work on it anymore. Я уже написала это письмо. Так, вот упражнение 11.8. Да, это упражнение 11.8. Я уже сделала это упражнение. Я уже сделала это упражнение. So, perfective verbs express single complete events. What do imperfective verbs express? Imperfective verbs express progressive, repeated or habitual actions. Things, actions that we perform every day or actions that last a while. Я долго читала этот журнал. It took me a long time to read this magazine. Я долго читала этот журнал. I read this magazine for a long time. Я долго читала эту газету. Я долго писала это письмо. Я делала это упражнение 2 часа. So, imperfective verbs express progressive actions, actions that last for a certain amount of time, and they also express repeated or habitual actions, actions that are performed every day. Ну, хорошо. And you remember that in the Russian language, verbs go in pairs. An imperfective verb has a perfective pair. And during our previous session, we looked at our first 4 imperfective-perfective verbal pairs. So let's take a look at these 4 verbs, verbal pairs one more time. Читать, прочитать, писать, написать, делать, сделать, строить, построить. Yeah? Читать, писать, делать, строить are imperfective verbs, and they express progressive and habitual actions. Прочитать, написать, сделать, построить are perfective verbs, and they express single complete events. Ну, хорошо. I asked you to go ahead and memorize these 4 imperfective-perfective verbal pairs. Okay, now very quickly, give me the perfective pairs of these verbs. Писать, написать, делать, сделать, читать, прочитать, and строить, построить. You should know this. This should be coming up just like that, very quickly. No thinking. You have to work on your memory. Читать, прочитать, писать, написать, делать, сделать, and строить, построить. Хорошо. Now let's take a look at a few examples with these verbs. Итак, посмотрите, пожалуйста, на эту картинку. And I want you to go ahead and read the caption in your classrooms. Она 2 часа писала письмо. She was writing this letter for 2 hours. Да? Она 2 часа писала письмо. Писала is an imperfective verb. It expresses a progressive action. Она 2 часа писала письмо. Хорошо, let's move on to our next picture. And again, I want you to read the sentence in your classrooms. Она уже написала письмо. And the verb написала is perfective or imperfective? Perfective. We are expressing an action that has been completed. Она уже написала письмо. And you remember that to emphasize the completeness of a certain action or event, we very often use the adverb уже, already. Она уже написала письмо. Хорошо? Let us move on. And again, I want you to read this sentence in your classrooms. Он делал уроки весь вечер. Could you, can you identify the aspect of the verb делал? Imperfective. Imperfective. We are expressing an action that lasted for a whole evening. Делал. Он делал уроки весь вечер. Хорошо, let us move on and please read this sentence in your classrooms. Он уже сделал уроки. Он уже сделал уроки. And сделал is what kind of a verb? Perfective. Сделал is a perfective verb. Again, this action has been completed. The homework has been done. Он уже сделал уроки. And the adverb уже helps us identify the aspect of that verb, right? Он уже сделал уроки. Хорошо. Next sentence, please. Строители долго строили дом. Строители долго строили дом. Again, we have an action that lasted for a certain amount of time. We know that it lasted долго, for a long time. So we have a progressive action here, and we express it by using an imperfective verb. Строили. We need an imperfective verb. Строители долго строили дом. Хорошо, and let's look at this picture. As you can see, the house has been built. This project has been completed. Строители уже построили этот дом. Строители уже построили этот дом. And построили is what kind of a verb? Perfective. Perfective. We are expressing a single complete event and we need a perfective verb in this sentence. Again, the adverb уже helps us a bit here. Строители уже построили этот дом. Ну, хорошо. So remember that perfective verbs express single complete events and imperfective verbs can only express habitual or progressive actions. Now I'm going to share this interesting fact with you. Imperfective verbs have 3 tenses, present, past, and future. We can talk about progressive actions or habitual actions in the present, in the past or in the future. Now, perfective verbs have only two tenses, the future tense and the past tense. Perfective verbs do not have the present tense. Isn't that curious? In fact, it's very, very logical. If an action is going on at the present moment as we speak, then it's not complete. So perfective verbs do not have the present tense because they express single complete events. They have only two tenses, the past tense and the future tense. An event can be complete in the past. Something was done and we were finished with it. Or you can think of a single complete event taking place in the future. Something will be done. But we can't express it in the present tense because if something is going on at the present moment, it hasn't been completed yet. So imperfective verbs have all the three tenses: the present tense, the future tense, the past tense. Perfective verbs have only two tenses, the past tense and the future tense. Ну, хорошо. Хорошо. А сейчас возьмите свои ручки или карандаши и давайте сделаем упражнение. I want you to complete the sentences in the past tense. Ну, хорошо, хорошо. Итак, давайте посмотрим, как вы сделали это упражнение. Номер один. Максим уже прочитал этот журнал. Итак, посмотрите, пожалуйста. Максим уже прочитал этот журнал. Can the adverb уже helps us with the choice of the verb here. Прочитал. He finished reading this magazine. Максим уже прочитал этот журнал. И номер два. Вчера я 2 часа читал, or читала. And you know, this depends upon your gender. Читал, or читала эту книгу. I read this book for 2 hours yesterday. Вчера я 2 часа. Now we know that this action lasted for 2 hours. Вчера я 2 часа читал, or читала эту книгу. Imperfective. So we have the perfective verb прочитал in the first sentence, and the imperfective verb читал or читала in the second sentence. Ну, хорошо. Хорошо. А сейчас давайте посмотрим маленький видеофильм. In this short video, you will hear 2 dialogues. I want you to follow these conversations very closely and please pay attention to the use of imperfective and perfective verbs here. Итак, давайте посмотрим этот маленький видеофильм. Пожалуйста.
Борис, ты уже сделал уроки?
Да, я уже все сделал. Сейчас я смотрю футбол по телевизору. А ты? Ты уже сделал уроки?
Нет, я еще не сделал математику. Стас, ты уже прочитал журнал «Москва»?
Еще нет. Я вчера читал весь вечер, но еще не все прочитал. Весь журнал очень интересный.
Ну, хорошо. Хорошо. I hope that you were following these conversations very closely, because certainly these conversations were very interesting in terms of how the verbs were used. Ты уже сделал уроки? Have you finished doing your homework? Ты уже сделал уроки? Да, я уже все сделал. I have already done everything. Ну, хорошо. And again, we will be discussing the use of perfective and imperfective verbs over and over again. And I hope that finally we will achieve perfect clarity. Ну, хорошо. Let's take a look at some more imperfective perfective verbal pairs. Рассказывать is paired with рассказать. Рассказывать, to tell a story. And the perfective verb is рассказать, to have told a story. Рассказать. Показывать, to show, is paired with показать. Показать. And начинать, to begin, is paired with начать, to have begun, to accomplish the act of beginning. Начинать. Начать. Рассказывать, рассказать, показывать, показать, and начинать, начать. Okay, now I will read only the imperfective verbs. I want you to read their perfective pairs. Рассказывать, рассказать, показывать, показать, начинать, начать, начать. Notice that these perfective verbs do not carry special prefixes. The change occurs within the verb. And that's what I was trying to warn you of during our previous lesson. You have to memorize your perfective imperfective pairs. There aren't any prefixes in the Russian language that will work for all verbs. In each case, you have to memorize the verbs. Ну, хорошо. Let's look at examples. Let's look at some examples. Итак, посмотрите, пожалуйста. Андрей долго рассказывал о Новосибирске. Андрей was telling a story about Novosibirsk for a long time. It took him a long time to tell us about Novosibirsk, right? And again, we know that this action, рассказывал, lasted for a long time, долго. So we have a progressive action, and we express it by using an imperfective verb. Андрей долго рассказывал о Новосибирске. But look at the second sentence. Андрей уже все рассказал. Андрей already told everything. Андрей уже все рассказал. And the adverb уже emphasizes the completeness of this situation. He told us everything. Андрей уже все рассказал. Хорошо. Let's look at another couple of examples. Андрей весь вечер показывал фотографии. And all evening Andrei was showing photographs. Весь вечер, all evening. This action lasted весь вечер. Andrei весь вечер показывал фотографии. And now let's read the example with a perfective verb. Он уже показал все фотографии. He already showed all photographs. Андрей уже показал все фотографии. So the second sentence describes a single complete event. He showed us all his photographs. He doesn't have anything else to show us. This action is perfectly complete. Он уже показал все фотографии. Хорошо, and let's look at these two sentences. Учительница всегда начинала урок в 9 часов. Let's talk a little bit about the situation. So the teacher would always begin the lesson at 9 o'clock. It's a repeated action, isn't it? The lesson, or the teacher would always begin the lesson at 9 o'clock. We have a repeated action, and we need an imperfective verb to describe it. Now let's look at the sentence closer to the bottom of the screen. Сейчас 9:05. Учительница уже начала урок. So it's 9:05. It's 5 minutes after 9 o'clock. 9:05. Учительница уже начала урок. The teacher has already begun the lesson. We're talking about this particular lesson that the teacher has already begun. Сейчас 9:05. Учительница уже начала урок. The teacher has gotten through the beginning of the lesson. She has begun the lesson. We have a perfect situation when we deal with a complete event. The act of beginning a lesson has been accomplished. Учительница уже начала урок. Хорошо. Хорошо. I know that this is difficult, but still we have to keep talking about the use of perfective and imperfective verbs. And at this point you may ask me, are there any rules for us to go by? Are there any words for us to look for that will help us with the choice of the verb? Well, yes, there are some. So let's take a look at the rules of aspect usage. And we shall begin with the rules for perfective verbs. Use perfective verbs when the adverb уже appears within a sentence. As you well know, this adverb emphasizes the completeness of events. Я уже прочитал эту книгу. I already finished reading this book. Я уже прочитал эту книгу. So, this is the only rule that will guide us towards perfective verbs. Now, there are more rules that will help us with imperfective verbs. So, let's look at this. Use imperfective verbs when one of the following adverbs appears within a sentence. Всегда, часто, редко, долго, обычно. Маша всегда делала уроки. Маша would always do her homework, right? We have a habitual or a repeated action here, so we need an imperfective verb. Маша всегда делала уроки. And if within a sentence you see one of these adverbs, всегда, часто, редко, долго, or обычно, you should use an imperfective verb. But do you know all of these adverbs? Let's check on their meanings. Всегда, по-английски always. Часто, often. Редко, seldom. Долго, for a long time. And обычно means usually. Всегда, часто, редко, долго, обычно. These verbs help us with imperfective verbs. You see one of these adverbs within a sentence, you know you should use an imperfective verb. Also, use imperfective verbs when you see a phrase expressing the duration of time. If a sentence contains a phrase expressing the duration of time, you need an imperfective verb. Максим делал уроки 2 часа. Хорошо. And now another rule. Use imperfective infinitives after the verbs meaning to begin, to continue, to end. Наташа начала делать уроки. After начала, which means begin, you have to use an imperfective infinitive. Наташа начала делать уроки. Джон начал. John began or started. Джон начал рассказывать об Америке. So after the verbs meaning to begin, to end, to continue, we have to use imperfective infinitives. Ну, хорошо. Well, let's practice with these rules. And there's a very good exercise in our textbook, exercise 11.8, that helps us with this. Now, what I want you to do is turn to page 200, find the exercise 11.8, look at the third part, рассказывать, and now I want you to take a few minutes and work on this exercise. All you need to write down is the verbs. Put down the number of the sentence and then the verbs. And remember that we are working with the past tense verbs, the use of the aspects in the past tense. Okay? Хорошо, хорошо. So let's look at the answers here. Итак, номер один. Олег долго рассказывал о работе в Академгородке, а потом начал рассказывать об институте, где он учился. Номер два. Когда Олег все рассказал, мы начали смотреть телевизор. Маша долго рассказывала о дедушке и бабушке, которые живут в деревне. Когда она все рассказала, мы начали играть в шахматы. Номер четыре. Владимир часто рассказывал о доме отдыха. И номер пять. Лариса недолго рассказывала о пассажире в самолете. In each of these sentences you can find the phrase or an adverb that explains the choice of the verb. Ну, хорошо. So at home I want you to continue practicing. Memorize all 7 verbal pairs and the rules of aspect usage. And then in your textbook on page 200, I want you to work on exercise 11.8a. And you will be working with the verbs читать, прочитать. And of course, right after this class, I want you to complete your additional exercises. Ну, хорошо. Большое спасибо и до свидания.